The nation was shocked last Friday when a gunman shot his way into Sandy Hook Elementary and killed 20 children, all just 6 or 7 years old, as well as 6 teachers and administrators. As the community mourns, school administrators around the country are revisiting emergency plans, hoping to make sure what happened in Newtown, Connecticut doesn't happen at their schools. I stopped by Oskaloosa Elementary School to see how they're dealing with the tragedy.
Oskaloosa School Resource Officer Craig Alexander says a big part of keeping the school safe is building relationships with the students.
The main thing is I get to know the kids. I'm around the kids. You know, I teach there in second grade, in fifth grade, and sixth grade. So I'm around pretty much since second grade, and I get to talk to them. I get to know them, build a relationship. So hopefully, if they have issues, they have problems, they feel comfortable coming to me and talking to me.
But if the unthinkable happens, Alexander says the key is to plan ahead.
So how do you guys prepare for a crisis like a school shooting?
Well, there's a plan. Obviously, the school has a plan. Actually, we do drills to prepare, you know, for officers, the school, a staff, and the kids. So that way they're aware, you know, in case there is a threat or an emergency or, you know, something going on here that we're concerned about, that they keep safe.
Superintendent Russ Ryder says he can't release specifics about the emergency plans for security reasons, but he says the plans are in place.
With regard to what happened in Connecticut on Friday, it really forced us to kind of go back and review what we've already got in place. Knowing that each and every year, routinely, we go through our process, we look and revisit, making sure that what we have in place is effective.
Ryder says he's gotten a few calls from parents asking about safety protocols. He wants to ensure them that safety is the district's top priority.
They're as safe as we can possibly make it at this particular point. We're going to continue on being very vigilant, making sure that we can do the best we can. We're going to continue to look at our locking systems. We're going to take a look at, we've got new video cameras that are up. We've got more video cameras that are coming in.
All to make sure if the worst happens, the schools will have done everything possible to keep students safe.
The front doors at all Oskaloosa schools are unlocked, but Ryder says the school remains safe because all visitors have to access the school through one entrance. Alexander says Oskaloosa schools routinely do 1 or 2 lockdown drills a year, but they haven't done one yet this school year.